Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. If alpha is bigger than 0 and less than 1, what is the limit of n plus 1 to the power of alpha minus n to the power of alpha as n goes to positive infinity? We are going to solve this question in two different ways. The first solution. This number is bigger than 0 because alpha is positive, n plus 1 is bigger than n, both are positive. Therefore, the difference is positive. We can factor out n to the power of alpha. Then we have this result. We can rewrite this fraction as n plus 1 divided by n to the same power alpha. Then split the inside part into two parts. N divided by n equals 1. Then plus 1 over n. Because this part is positive, this part is positive. Alpha is between 0 and 1. We can increase this number. We replace alpha by 1. That means this part is less than n to the power of alpha times 1 plus 1 over n to the power of 1 minus alpha. Simplify the inside part. 1 minus 1 are canceled out. Then we have n to the power of alpha times 1 over n. Rewrite n to the power of alpha as 1 over n to the power of negative alpha. Simplify the right-hand side. We have 1 over n to the power of 1 minus alpha. Now, this number is between the two numbers. The left-hand side is 0. The right-hand side is 1 over n to the power of 1 minus alpha. Because alpha is between 0 and 1, therefore 1 minus alpha is also between 0 and 1, which is positive and less than 1. Therefore, the limit of 1 over n to the power of 1 minus alpha goes to 0 as n goes to positive infinity because 1 minus alpha is positive. The left-hand side is 0. The right-hand side goes to 0 as n goes to positive infinity. Therefore, the middle part must go to 0. By the sandwich theorem, we have the limit of n plus 1 to the power of alpha minus n to the power of alpha equals 0 as n goes to positive infinity. The second method, we use calculus. We define t equals 1 over n. Therefore, n equals 1 over t. As n goes to positive infinity, t goes to 0 from the right-hand side. The original limit can be rewrite in terms of t, which is limit of 1 over t plus 1 to the power of alpha minus 1 over t to the power of alpha as t goes to 0 from the right-hand side. Simplify the inside part. We have limit of 1 plus t to the power of alpha minus 1 divided by t to the power of alpha as t goes to 0 from the right-hand side. we can split t to the power of alpha into a product of t to the power of alpha minus 1 times t. We can rewrite this limit as a product of two limits if both limits exist. First limit certainly goes to zero because 1 minus alpha is positive. T goes to zero from the right-hand side. Now we need to derive the second limit. How? We use calculus idea. If f of x equals x to the power of alpha, the first order derivative of f of x equals alpha times x to the power of alpha minus 1. The first order derivative of f of x at x equals 1 equals alpha. We can replace x by 1. Then we have this result. By the original definition of the first order derivative at point 1, which is the limit of f of 1 plus t minus f of 1 divided by t. What is f? F equals x to the power of alpha. Therefore, we have 1 plus t to the power of alpha minus 1 divided by t. As t goes to 0, this is the definition. This looks the same like this, except this is the limit from both sides. This is the limit only from the right-hand side. What is this? This is the f prime of 1, which is alpha. Therefore, the limit of this equals alpha. Certainly, the limit as t goes to 0 from the right-hand side also equals alpha. Now, we are ready to derive this limit. The first limit is 0. The second limit is alpha. 0 times alpha is 0. This is the answer. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.